beautiful.
Oh,
wow.
Oh, that is beautiful.
I actually never thought I'd be this excited over other things than gold.
Did you find $1 million stone?
Good morning or good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the channel if you're new to it. My name is...
Avianca!
Yo, Paul!
Yeah, I'm good.
You good?
I'm good. Today, I'm at a piece of land that my friend Dan Hurd owns, and it's home of what's called Ocean Picture Stone. It's a beautiful stone that where when you cut it, sometimes you get an image of like an ocean picture. Our goal here today is to find the best piece we can because for one, it's beautiful, and two, artists and jewelers will pay top dollars for them. So let's go. So I didn't bring any tools with me because I've never actually done this before. Tell us about this stuff because I have no idea what I'm doing, but I brought my gold pen.
Okay. Excellent, excellent. There is actually gold in this rock.
Really?
Nothing you're gonna find in your pen.
This is the Ocean Picture Stone Quarry.
Used by lapidary artists and jewelers to make jewelry out of. We call it a gemstone, but it's not one that you'd facet, you know. But you still make gems out of it. You can polish it, you can do all sorts of stuff, carve with it. People love the stuff.
This is completely out of my realm. I'm usually, as you guys know, I'm into prospecting only. I saw the last video that he did with this Ocean Picture Stone and I said, you know, I have to have a taste of that. Here we are, and I'm gonna take all of his Ocean Picture Stone.
Thief, glad to have Polly here. It's so fun doing anything with Polly. Fun doing stuff with the youth of today. Not you. Old guy like me.
Youth, I'm like 100 years old.
Yeah.
Looks like a beach, little islands in there. That's really cool.
Exactly.
But yeah, I'm excited. This is the first video I'm actually doing that's not prospecting.
And you know, I've been gold panning for like 10, 15 years now. And in the 3 months I've owned this claim, I've recovered more value of this than I've done in gold in my entire gold panning career.
Apparently what, you sold $40,000 worth of gold.
I'm probably up
stuff
closer to 50 now.
Holy cow, well, how much is this one worth?
That would sell for like a buck.
A dollar?
Maybe.
Wow, I want it though, it's really nice. Cool, well let's start panning, oh sorry.
Panning, yes.
Yeah.
There's all
this
stuff you can pan out, you'll find absolutely nothing.
Woo!
Guarantee it.
Oh yeah.
You may find chunks of my chisel. So Paul, you're not gonna be using the drill and feather and wedges and those kind of things. Most likely what you'll wanna do is grab one of the chisels, grab one of the big hammers, find a chunk that you like, and the trick is to get underneath it to start with. Go down below the good stuff, find a nice spot below the good, and start wedging in there. And you have to hit hard to break this stuff free. And here we go. We got a nice one coming.
Oh. That's just so cool.
It's loose, just have to get it out of the rock now. That there would sell on my website for $75. That's a 1 pound piece of what I would consider premium material.
And what makes it premium?
There's a bunch of different things that would make a rock premium. This one here has the deep, deep blue, the really nice blue, and a nice bottom host layer, so you can make a good beach scene out of that. Even this little guy, that would be a piece of premium. Small, if someone wanted small pieces to make up a pound, that would be one of the pieces in a premium bag.
Holy cow.
How did this come to be, this type of rock?
That's a whole geology course in itself, but basically what it is the bedrock has fractures in it naturally, all over the place. If water deep down in the Earth's crust gets hot enough, it starts to boil and force its way up into those cracks. As it's boiling way down under pressure, it dissolves quartz, gold, all sorts of things, and it forces the way into the cracks, making the cracks bigger as it forces in. And then when it gets to a certain height in the crust, the pressure and temperature is just right that quartz can't stay in solution anymore, and it falls out and it deposits. Why this deposit is so beautiful is that quartz had a little bit of some sort of metal in it that colored it blue. Most of these hydrothermic veins are just white quartz. Very seldom you get these blue things or any other color.
I'm sure I'm supposed to pull this one out. Yeah, I can't seem to pry that big chunk out.
Right down where you were just where you were digging, there's a couple of nice pieces down under your foot there.
I believe Dan was here yesterday at this spot, but wow, that just looks so good. That looks like more of a lake. Okay, so for those of you who don't know, this is Bianca. Her nickname is Sita. And she just found a little corner of this blue. Like, you see that? We started cleaning it, and then she's starting to discover that this whole thing is covered in it. It's everywhere. She found it in the ground. See, this is what I should be doing, looking in the ground instead of chipping at the wall. Whole bunch of little islands and stuff. Like I said, you can cut that right through and have like a real nice picture. Show that to Dan. He'll poop himself.
Hey, look at what I found!
That is a nice one. That is amazing.
So cool.
Way to go.
Well, that's very nice blue. Wow.
So they're nothing or it's good. I love that color so much. Wow. If this isn't valuable, it doesn't matter to me. I still like it. That is so cool. Now we gotta find this color and a proper beach. Oh, we'll keep that though and keep looking. I just left my tools at the bottom of the hill, so I gotta go and get them.
I brought some of your tools for you.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. My toothbrush in my car. Thank you, this will help. This will really help.
Oh yeah!
Well, heard Danielle.
That is the way to slab this stuff off. You come to join us!
Lady.
I just extracted the most amazing rock. Have a look. I was using feather and wedges. That's what the drill holes are from the feather and wedges. Three drill holes, split it off perfectly. That is an awesome piece.
So you could cut it through this and have a flat polished piece.
We could cut right through there. We would have the beach on the bottom with the host. We'd have the water, the ocean, and then the white would be the sky, the clouds. And this one even has like a mountain poking up through the clouds in the distance. That is awesome.
I actually never thought I'd be this excited over other things than gold, but
holy cow. Reminds me of like the waters in Australia. For sure, I'm gonna be addicted real quick. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I am pretty much addicted now. Squirt myself too.
Hey!
I just stepped on a rattlesnake for the very first time. Let me know if you guys can hear that. Can you guys hear that? But there's a nice piece of blue Pryxia stone right there too. What to risk, getting bit or a beautiful rock? So this whole mountain is covered in the ocean Pryxia stone, and we were just at quarry, I think number two, and there's three, four, five. So we're just kind of walking up this hill and looking for another place to hopefully find some of this stuff with less rattlesnakes. Gonna knock this rock down.
Polly, you're gonna wanna see this one. You can pry like the top go that way, see if it pulls it out.
Yeah.
Wiggle it. Wiggle it, Polly, wiggle it.
Oh!
That's a nice piece. Broke up a few, but nice piece.
You have like a couple rivers and stuff in there.
Yeah, and there's more to come too.
Look at those colors. Wow, that's a nice little island.
Wow. Those are all great.
And you can sell each one of those, eh?
Yep, that would go into a chip bag. That's about a half pound chip bag right there.
Oh, look. Those are nice.
Oh, that is beautiful.
Super cool. Yeah, those colors are deep.
$250 rock, that one.
Wow.
Here we go.
It's a nugget. I like the dark blues in that one. Nice.
That's beauty, eh?
I like that. You can see like the bands in it.
Yeah, the whole ocean scene in one little chip, eh?
Wow. Yeah. I think I could shave with this.
You might be able to. Are you old enough to shave?
Not yet. Not yet. Not until my voice cracks.
Oh, you missed the bucket.
Dang it.
Let's see what they found. Oh, yeah. There's a nice blue. Look at that.
So I just found this nice chunk. This one is loose, so I'm gonna pull that beauty out, and then I'm gonna dig down, kind of just see what else is here.
Look at that, you got multiple islands on that one. That's cool.
That's a good one.
That's a nice one. Yeah, can you wiggle that one out?
Oh,
look at that.
Look at that, eh?
That's cool.
Whoa. Dan's gonna be happy with that. It's got like calcium or something here on it.
Yeah, that's gonna be nice.
A little more bright.
Ah, there you go. Let's look at I love this stuff. This is actually so nice. I'm just kidding. So according to Dan, underneath this dirt, if it's blue, that means there's another nice seam underneath it.
There you go. That'll be enough for you to see if it's blue or not. Yeah.
And it's blue.
It's blue.
Well, I'm gonna move some of the stuff out of the way and see if we can find another seam.
Polly found his spot. Oh. There it is.
There we go. Yeah, look at that. Holy cow. So that would continue. Look how dark that blue is though, too, up there. That's cool.
And how far down does it go? Like,
That is addictive.
I'm playing in mud.
Really nice if the blue is capped or the bottom with white, because that makes the ocean scene look like it has clouds.
I know I have ocean picture stone fever, if that's even a thing. I have gold fever. This is difficult. This is really hard.
Got it. Go, Polly, go.
Look at that blue in there. Holy.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm falling in love with this kind of stuff now.
It's a boy.
Yeah, I like the dark blues in there. That's so cool.
Hit it, man. Hit it. Hit it like you mean it. There you go. You got it. Hit it. Hit it harder.
The whole top slab is moving.
Can you grab that pry bar? I don't know what you could really use this piece for, but...
Yeah, if there's no inclusions or no host, then they're making cabochons out of just the straight blue, which they do. They love that as well. And this is a perfect blue for that, and still big enough for it. So, yeah, that's a usable rock.
Woohoo! The whole thing moved up like a quarter inch.
You're a quarter inch.
No, I'm way bigger than a quarter inch, man.
Yeah. Some nice blues. Right under here. So Keith, our camera guy, is one of the strongest here, next to Bianca, obviously. He's giving it a shot, trying to peel this piece of slab off.
Okay, the magic reveal. Oh!
They got some nice
blue. Look at
blues.
The blue on that.
Look at that, and look at the hosts inside of it.
Yes.
That makes perfect scenes.
10 points.
Oh, look at that blue too.
It's dark.
It's dark.
Does Polly win the award for best specimen today?
He might.
Look at that blue.
Wow, that's a nice one. I can balance this on my lip. Oh, that crack.
Wow. Oh, he's on crack.
Hercules.
You want to spray it?
Oh,
wow.
There's one for your thumbnail, man.
Yeah. Wow, look at that.
We got a lot here.
That's a nice slab right there.
Nice.
Look how dark that is.
That's so awesome.
Is that more ideal with the white swirled in with it?
Oh, yeah. That's amazing.
That's incredible.
This could be amazing. It could be an absolute dud. I have no idea what to expect inside here, but it's loose for sure. Oh, yeah.
Ooh, there's a nice one.
Without killing myself.
Yeah.
Beach, yep. Ocean rocks, water, sky above. There it is. Woo, my leg! And that's gonna be a specimen all on its own. That's probably what, 40 pounds? Actually, that's probably gonna give you a better idea of what the overall rock's gonna look like, right
look
there.
At that. So you see the beach there, you see the water.
The feather and wedges, that is the way to go. I would have been working on that for a day to get that out without those.
Wow.
Score!
Dan, you have then it. You can cut this one.
Oh yeah! That was just laying in the muck there?
Yep.
That's a specimen right there.
That's a real nice big piece. Dan was saying I could sell this all just as this without cutting it or anything. And you can get a good couple cents out of that one. So what I'm doing right now is just kind of doing lazy man's work and moving rocks out of the way to see if I can find anything nice. Hello. That I could keep. The goal is to find something valuable.
Oh,
Oh my god.
Holy cow!
What, did you find the $1 million stone?
They never learn.
So that is it for today. We're we are done for today. We have plenty and plenty and plenty of ocean picture stone to take home. I gotta thank this guy, this weird guy, Dan Hurd, for letting me go on his claim and find as much rock as we did. Thank you, Dan.
You are welcome.
I'm tired. I gotta get out of here. This is way too hot for me. So let's get back to the house, have a closer look of what we found. So, I never thought I would end up in this room to show you guys something that wasn't gold. Ocean picture stone. Now, we found some beautiful, rich, oceany pieces, including this big chunk Sita found for us, which we were able to cut a few slabs from and now have something new to put on my shelf. No, this isn't some sort of sponsorship deal I got going on with Dan. I'm just stating the facts. This type of gemstone is very rare and the quantity is very limited. So if you do want to get your hands on some, Dan's website is in the description. If you enjoyed this video, chances are you're going to enjoy what I've previously posted and is coming in the future. So please don't hesitate hitting that subscribe button. But if you're watching this on Facebook, please hit that like button and check out my social media for more. Thank you all for watching. Thank you so much for your support. And until the next one, black screen. With logo.
My toothbrush in my car.
Thank you, this will help.